In November of 1915, Albert Einstein presented his field equations of general relativity to the Prussian Academy of Science. This was a revolutionary idea in physics at the time that fundamentally changed our understanding of how the universe works.
This year, it is exactly 100 years old. It has created an entire field of relativistic astrophysics and general relativity.
Well, physicists worldwide have coordinated together to create a series of commemorative experiences, ranging from conferences, for example, several in Rio, Penn State, including the most recent AAAS, and most notably at the April APS meeting. General relativity has transformed the way physicists work, even on a day-to-day basis, changing the tools that we use to understand and describe the natural world. And of course, it's a fabulously successful theory of gravity.
Among its most astonishing prediction is the existence of gravitational waves and black holes. This is the area, our center here at Rochester Institute of Technology, the Center for Computational Relativity and Gravitation, is working on.
General relativity is important for neutron star calculations. They're relativistic objects. Many of the elements we see in the universe were created by neutron star mergers, and it takes a sophisticated level of nuclear physics in order to make accurate predictions and really be able to test models.
Here at RIT, we're fortunate to have in the CCRG one of the world's foremost research groups in gravitational astrophysics and general relativity. We also have the Center for Detectors and the Laboratory for Multi-Wavelength Astrophysics. So we can offer students a wide range of research projects.
My own research is on simulations of binary black hole mergers. This is a field which is called numerical relativity, which is about solving the Einstein's field equations numerically to describe what happens during the collisions of black holes.
So the CCRG is a great place to study numerical relativity because we have our own in-house supercomputing resources, in addition to allocations in some of the nation's largest computing resources for scientific computing.
I work with Carlos Lusto. We're interested in what happens when black holes are spinning very, very quickly. We think that in the universe, these black holes will be spinning nearly as fast as they can. In order to find out what's going to happen at the end stage of their merger, when they're orbiting very close to each other, we need to use full numerical relativity. This requires a lot of computational resources, which are available here at the CCRG.
So my research and my students' research is really cutting edge. We are in big data. We produce very large data sets. We run simulations on massive government supercomputers that run for a very long time. It's kind of teaching students that the tools and techniques that they need to do physics calculations and other calculations in the real world at kind of an internet or big data scale.
Several members of the CCRG, myself included, and most notably also Professor John Whalen, are members of the LIGO Scientific Collaboration, or LSC. The LSC works together, all collaborating to analyze the information from this interferometric gravitational wave detector, which is measuring the transverse stretching and squeezing of a set of arms as a gravitational wave passes by.
The CCRG is extremely active in outreach efforts, both at RIT and in the greater community. There's the AstroDance project, which is an innovative combination of science and art.
And RIT is extremely unique in that we have this one college where we have about, at any given time, about 1,500 deaf and hard of hearing students on campus. We are an extremely diverse campus. You'll see hearing students signing with deaf students and deaf students communicating with hearing students. And as part of that, we're kind of building programs where deaf and hard of hearing students can become involved in astrophysics research and can pursue their interests in astrophysics if they have them. And we're especially unique in that we have a graduate program here. And if you're a graduate student and you want to study astronomy or astrophysics or relativity and you're deaf or you're hard of hearing, there aren't many places in the world you can go to actually pursue that. We're probably the only place, the only institution of higher education where you can come and you can study with a PhD advisor who communicates with you in your own language.
Modern astrophysics is a collaborative effort in which observation, theory, and computer simulations are more closely interwoven than ever before. So researchers need a working knowledge of subfields beyond their particular areas.
In a sense, we're all a big team approaching the huge problem of basically uncovering an entire new field and we can't each individually tackle all of the possible puzzles ourselves. So we work together as a team to cover all of our bases.
Coincidentally, after this century celebration of Einstein's generativity, the physics community may witness a new discovery, the discovery of gravitational waves. In fact, the advanced LIGO detector is getting ready to observe such gravitational waves in just a few years from now. And when that will happen, then a new window into the universe will be opened.